This that I'm going to show you now is the basis of inversion. It's actually the basis of valley climates, especially during the evening. Now, what we've got here is that we've got here katabatic winds and inversions. Now you remember this is happening during the night, right? Now, easy to remember, katabatic during the night. Cats walk during the night. Okay, here we go. So what happens is that the air has cooled off. And what happens when air cools off? It sinks down the valley slope. Have you got that? Look at our arrows here. The cold air sinks down the valley slope. Very, very important that you see that. Now, as it sinks down the valley slope, this warm air is being displaced upwards. Now, what's happening now? This means that here was warm air and here was cold air. But the cold air forced the warm air out. Now the warm air is on top and the cold air is at the bottom. But you know, you say, hang on. Isn't it that the higher I go, the colder you get? You're right. But we are dealing here with inversions. That is why. What is an inversion? An inversion is when the temperature increases with altitude. Let's just put it for you bluntly. The higher you go, the warmer it will get. Okay. So this means that here I'm going to get warm air instead of cold air because the cold air forced the warm air out. Okay. This means, because it's so cold there at the bottom, I'm going to get a frost pocket there. I'm going to get smog there. And we are going to have huge problems for farmers because he won't be able to plant all his crops here. He will have to plant frost-resistant crops here. And those who are sensitive to crops, to frost, he will have to park, to plant there. Now, this is the basis of valley climates. Now, during the day, just the opposite happens. What happens? Your valley has been heated, right? And what happens today? It rises up the slope, and then you get your anabatic effect. But these ones that we're talking about here, these ones are the ones that usually tested because of the big influence it has on humans and the settlements. Okay, let's have a look now. Now, you must remember that this air, as it moves down the slope, then it means there was a high pressure on the slope, and here in the valley was a low pressure because winds or air always moves from a high pressure towards a low pressure. Now, this forms the basis of this exam question. And this exam question is very, very important. Last year, here's the question. Study the diagram on valley climates, and I must answer the questions that follow. Let's have a look at this. Name the wind 1 in sketch A. Here's sketch A, the wind 1. Right. Now remember, it can only be one of two, the katabatic or the anabatic one. So, that's it. So we've got the anabatic one here in the day and the katabatic one during the night that we've got there. Okay. Now, the second question. State one difference between the winds 1 and 2. See, there's winds blowing there and these winds 2 blowing there. Right. What's the difference between them? Here we've got it. Firstly, the one occurs during the day. This one. Am I right? And this one occurs during the night. First difference. Second difference, what we've got here is that this one is occurs because of heating. In other words, it's warm air that rises. This one has to do with cold air that sinks. Another difference between the two. Another difference between the two would be that this one, wind blows from the valley upwards, and this one blows down the slope. Okay, so those are the differences between these winds that we've got. Now, here we've got, would wind 1 or 2 originate if a higher pressure occurred at the top of valley? Which one of these two would occur when the higher pressure is at the top of the valley? Remember what we have learned in grade 11. We've learned that winds always blow from a high pressure to a low pressure. Remember that. Okay, so the question says, where would wind 1 or 2 originate if a higher pressure was at the top of the valley slope? Now, let's have a look. Top of the valley. So this means, that's it. Winds always blow from a high pressure to a low pressure. Look at my arrows there. Okay? So that's very important. And the reason, therefore, is that the wind blows from the high pressure to the low pressure. Very important that you should know that. Okay. This one, actually, the students didn't answer this one very well. Explain why visibility on the valley floor, this year at 3 at the bottom, is less on winter mornings. Draw a label diagram to support your answer. Remember what I said about diagrams? Very important. So, Why is visibility less? Visibility is less because we've got a lot of smog and pollutants here. What's happening? This is happening. The cold air rolls down the valley. Here we've got it, right? And the inversion traps the smog here at the bottom, right? And in the result is that you have poor visibility. Now, you had to, the matrix last year had to supply a diagram as well. Can you see where the diagrams come in, why it's so important? They would have got 2 marks for the direction, and they would have got 2 marks if they indicated the correct place where smog has been formed. Matrix, do you see why I'm saying your diagrams are so very, very important? Okay, so please practice your diagrams. These are easy marks, people, okay? And see that you really can get the maximum marks when you write your exams or tests.